Awarded by fraternities of the two schools, the old wagon wheel is at the root of today's bitter rivalry. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Brigham Young is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. Fielded at the 9. Brought down at the 30-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He's going to try and scramble. They'll bring him down at the 36-yard line. They make the stop at the 38. Fires it out. He's tackled around the 45-yard line.
That is just sound fundamental football right there, making it look so easy.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. He's tackled around the 41-yard line. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Down at about the 33-yard line. They'll line it up again on third down. Fires out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 25.
This guy's got the combination of smarts and reliability that makes a receiver really dangerous. No wonder he's looked to on third down.
Tackle made at the 26.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
And he's taken down around the 17-yard line. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. 2 for 2 so far on this drive. He's taken down around the 3-yard line. Touchdown, Aggies. And a halfback took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
So they had their chances to stop him, but in the end, he comes up with a big play. And he hits the PAT. An 11-play, 69-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
He'll return it from the 1. And he's taken down at the 27. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Under heavy pressure. He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 27-yard line. Second down.
He gets hit out of bounds
at the 37. So the Aggies saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there.
Tackled for a loss. They'll bring him down at the 33. The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
Utah State is up a score.
He scrambled, and he can't get away from the pressure.
Around the 44-yard line. He's scrambling. They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line. He's on the run, and they make the stop at the 32-yard line. Takes the ball inside, and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. And so it's another third down upcoming here.
That's a great tackle at the 40.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
Utah State is hoping to make this a two-score game. Kicks away.
No good. He hooked it left.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. They go with the runner. He's taken down behind the line. It's second and 13. Ball on the 36. Pass complete and taken down immediately. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He's going to be sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Utah State showing no fear early in this football game, Kirk, and they're looking for the upset.
They are looking for the upset. And the longer they stick around in a game like this, I think the more that they believe they can actually pull it off. It looks like we may have ourselves a ball game today.
Hey, check my
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up.
Gets to about the 44-yard line.
Utah State is up 7. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Slings it out and it gets tipped.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid fundamental pass defense.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. He gets to about the 34-yard line. He zips it. He gets another, and this is a big one. Stop behind the line. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. Once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
That was just an excellent individual effort to find the end zone.
And he converts the extra point. Coles, ready to kick. Milne, from the two. Oh, what a hit. So the Aggies are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you talk to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. From their own 26-yard line. It's second down. Five wide.
Mic check, 33.
He's tackled around the 38-yard line. Comes to an end, and this one might raise a few eyebrows around the country. 14-0, Utah State. Back to the action now here in the second quarter.
Mike check, 33. I got you, pump.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. From their own 39-yard line. It's second down. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. They come out in a 5-wide set. Caught, and he's hit immediately. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Ready!
22.
Man, did he ever sell the run? The defense took the bait, and that hesitation was enough to give the receiver room to make the catch.
From the 22-yard line, first down. He fights forwards about the 19. This is the eighth play of this drive.
Ain't going nowhere. Mike check 33.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. The middle. Unbelievable. They can't get this offense off the field.
Oh, they've been like a machine on this drive. Very methodical and efficient. And once again, they're moving the chains.
10th play of the drive. Nice run, and he's brought down. From the 1 yard line, second down. A little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Mike check 33.
33. Set! 59.
Decent run here, right side. Around 4 yards there on the quarterback keeper. The defense backed up into their own end zone. It's third and goal from the one. On the throw, incomplete pass. Down, Cougars.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Brigham Young lines up for the kickoff. He's tackled at the 33-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Utah State is up by a touchdown. He sails it long. Inside the 30. He hauls it in. Very clutch tackle there because this kid had some space. And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
Gets to about the 14-yard line. Makes it out to about the 11-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. And they got him.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
Fourth down,
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Utah State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. The kick is up, and he got it. Coles has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. From the 5-yard line, he's out to the 30. Tackle made the 37-yard line.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
Now he's scrambling. Decides to slide.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
From the 49-yard line, first down. And down he goes, around the 47-yard line.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
Mike, check, 33.
Double! Shift! Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's taken down at the 49-yard line. 4 yards on that play.
You know, little passes like this force the defense to start to come up. Then you can see an offense take their chances downfield later to take advantage of the defense starting to cheat up.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39.
Coverage, and this one's going to be picked off.
Brad, I'm going to put that one on the quarterback. I think he's forcing the issue out there. I understand you're down a couple scores and you're trying to get back into the game, but you can't get it all back at once. You've got to be patient, take your time, and methodically work yourself back as a team back into this game.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42. Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
He makes his way out to about the 35. Throwing, I don't think he got anything on that. Not much there on the screenplay. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Kicks up, and it sails right on him. No good. We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
He's taken down around the 48-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 48. Tackle made at about the 49. The Cougars use their second timeout. He's going to try and scramble. Slides down.
easy, easy, easy. Lucky, lucky.
Take four.
Hey.
He heaves it to the end zone. No, incomplete. The punter is going to try to pin him deep in their own territory with a good punt here. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Utah State's done what they had to do offensively. They've done a nice job here in the first half, Harder.
Boy, it's been very consistent for them, and consequently, they have a nice lead here going into halftime. But again, they've got to be able to do a nice job here of continuing to fight, because this offense they're facing across the line of scrimmage on the other side of the ball, they can score in a hurry, so there's still a lot of football to be played.
Makes it to the 31.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass.
First and 10, ball on the 31. Pass right, running back's got it. Tackle right around the 40. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Looking for his man, incomplete. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. We've reached halftime, and I don't think too many people were expecting this. 17-7, Aggies.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Neither ground game got much going in the first half, averaging a little less than 3 yards per rush. David, as you look at this, look, you always hear the term get the offense behind the chains. When you get them in long yardage situations, what does that do for a defense?
Well, it's so much fun. You start with a defensive line, you know it's a pass. You get to fly up field as fast as you want to. It's not third and three where you're sitting in a situation where they could run or they could pass, and there's a little bit of doubt in your mind when you're coming. You fly up field, you rush the passer. Everybody knows that the sticks are a little bit further back, so DBs can back up a little bit and play to the sticks as opposed to playing third and short situations. It makes it easier on a whole defense.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's to the 20. So the Aggies continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Tackled after a decent pickup. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Gets hit out of bounds at the 37. Complete. He's got room. Brought down around the 40-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 40. tackles him hard at the 43-yard line.
Drop deep, drop deep. Mike check, 33.
Let's go!
He makes his way to about the 48. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires across the middle. There's a very impressive open field tackle. He's at the 30, to the 10. Touchdown, BYU!
Now you're looking at someone who makes a defense nervous because not every quarterback can break off a run like that. He's a real talent.
Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. He makes the PAT. Brigham Young to kick. He's out to the 30. And down he goes at the 31.
The Cougars came into the second half. They looked like they were just going to cruise to a victory. Right now, they better turn it around or they could lose this lead.
You're right. I don't know what happened at halftime. Maybe they were worried about the press clippings after this game. If they better get things in order, they could end up losing this ball game.
We're about set to start things up again. Utah State has a 3-point lead. Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Runs it right. Nice pickup. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. The corner. They'll bring him down at the 43. And he's hit immediately. Tackled at the 32-yard line. From the 32-yard line, it's first down. And they make the stop right around the 38-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Come to my work. We won't. Come to my work. Run.
He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
Yeah. You don't want none.
Utah State holds a field goal lead.
Jim.
He makes it to the 32-yard line. So it's fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. He gets it up, and he just drilled it from long range. They line up to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play can win this game.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. They go with the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled at about the 35. He's at midfield. He's pushed out of bounds at the 44-yard line. From the 44-yard line, first down. And a quick throw. And he is drilled at the 34-yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. There's a strike complete. And down he goes at about the 29-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Gains his way to the 20-yard line. It left for a decent game. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 15. They try to get a head start there. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
Two times. Go down.
Mike, check, 33.
Ready. Three for five.
He's under some heat, and they get the sack.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Five wide. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
10th play of the drive. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. With a quick throw. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go.
They put everyone up on the line. Takes a handoff. Tackled for a loss. And this is the 12th play of the drive.
Four down.
Mike, check, 33.
Pitch out, got the corner. And he's taken down just outside the goal line.
So with one quarter remaining, the Aggies lead 20-14. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. And we're all tied up. Here's the extra point that can give them the lead. And he tacks on the extra point.
A 13-play, 80-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Brigham Young lines up for the kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 30.
Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for 6 that time.
A field goal potentially wins this game for the offense. And right now, if the defense is smart, they'll do a good job of maintaining their aggressive attitude, try to get after the quarterback the best they can, try to keep the wide receivers inbound, and try to keep that clock moving, not allow this team to get into field goal range.
They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
Here we go, let's bring it. Let's go, let's bring it. Let's bring it.
Hey.
So the defense gets him to go 3 and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt.
He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're headed in the right direction.
A score here might effectively end this one.
Brigham Young with a 1-point lead. He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 47. From the 47-yard line. First down. Slings it. He's taken down around the 45-yard line. They come out in a 5-wide set. Just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37.
Ready, cut!
They'll make the sack.
Man, it's an offensive lineman. This is the worst thing that you want to see. Your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Receiver's got it on the screen. He's to the 40. And he's shoved out of bounds around the 46-yard line. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is. So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here. So the penalty puts him back for a first and long.
Tight right, tight right.
takes it to the 22-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. They come out on an empty backfield. He makes his way to about the 32. He lets it go. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
And he's taken down at the 32. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Brigham Young, up a point. And he's level at the 35. From their own 35-yard line, second down. For a loss.
I think the corner is the toughest position to play in football. You have to be athletic enough to be able to run with wide receivers and willing to be able to come up and make plays like this to be able to stop the run. This is a big time play by a corner, showing the versatility to be able to come up and be physical in the run game.
Moves up in the pocket and down he goes. That makes four sacks today.
Well, this speed is difficult to defend because you have to try to keep them off balance so they can't use their quickness.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Brought down around the 44-yard line. Gets out to around the 32. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's at the 20. He gets out to about the 17-yard line. Big opening. Tackle around the 2-yard line. Flushed and they got him. From the 6-yard line, second down. And he hits him hard at the 13-yard line. Should be makeable. Kicks up, and it's good.
And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
Utah State kicked this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 27. The Cougars have played poorly all day long. That really doesn't matter right now.
They've played sloppy. They're not going to be happy when they go back and look at the film on Monday. But with all that being said, they still have a chance to win this game. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters, is trying to get that W.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And he tackles him hard at the 28. Goes out of bounds
around the 32-yard line.
From their own 32-yard line, third down. Here's the throw to the fullback. He's tackled at about the 45. Quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. He goes downtown, almost picked off. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Quickly, and he's got his man. They'll bring him down right around the 40. He's going right. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. From the 22-yard line, it's first down. Under a minute left. And it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, and they take the lead. So the offense is going to go for two. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And they won't get the two.
Well, it didn't work out here, but I won't fault the coaches for going for two. This is a situation where you need the points.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 30-yard line.
Good job, good job.
Well, this is the chance. Late in the fourth quarter, they're behind, but they've got an opportunity now to come back and win it. Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41.
Mike 34, Mike 34. Scoot, scoot, scoot.
He's on the run. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
Check. He scrambled. And they make the stop around the 30-yard line. So the quarterback tucked it away and picks up the first.
He didn't have to go very far, so instead of taking a chance through the air, he did it himself. That's a nice play.
Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss. The spike will stop the clock.
Third and long here. And for the defense, if they get a stop, they've got a great opportunity to help put this football game away.
He wants it all. They've done it. I can't believe it. Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Well, folks, do you think we can see another Cal Stanford? They need to return this all the way to win it. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. And the ball game's over, and our final score in this one, 30-27, Aggies. As we wrap this game up, Kirk, what final thoughts do you want to share?
Nothing adds to the pageantry of college football more than a good rivalry. This was a great game that should only add more fuel to the fire for next year's matchup, and boy, was it fun to watch.
So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.